Polyhalogen compounds. So, what the word mean? Poly. So, poly means so many, and halogen means halogen elements. So, the word itself, poly. What do we understand by this word poly? So, many halogen. Many halogen containing compounds, that is polyhalogen compounds. And let's see which examples can be possible. CH2 Cl2, that is dichloromethane or methylene chloride. CHCl3, that is chloroform. CHI3, that is iodoform. We will see DDT and BHC also. BHC is benzene hexachloride. Freon, CF2 Cl2 and CCl4, carbon tetrachloride. You know CF2 Cl2 is freon. Now let's have this 2 chlorine, 3 chlorine, CHI3, 3 iodine in DDT. So total it has 5 chlorine atoms, BHC has 6 chlorine atoms, 2 fluorine and 2 chlorine, and 4 chlorine atoms. So, all these are, by definition, you can say they are polyhalogen compounds. Right? So, we will study the preparations of all these, then we will study physical and chemical properties and uses, and finally, if there be any environmental or physiological effects. Dichloromethane, CH2Cl2, methylene chloride, many times referred as methylene dichloride also. You can see its formula CH2Cl2. If you want to give its IUPAC name, it can be written as 1,1 dichloro and methane. So it's 1,1 dichloromethane. We'll see its preparation, properties, uses, and physiological effect. Preparation. Dichloromethane is formed by reduction of chloroform CHCl3 in presence of Zn plus HCl. You can see here that metal reacts with acid. That always forms hydrogen, and this hydrogen is used over here. One hydrogen will react with one chlorine to remove HCl, and the other hydrogen will join with that to give us the dichloromethane or methylene chloride. In recent time, dichloromethane is prepared by chlorination of methane. We know that in presence of ultraviolet radiation, free radical mechanism takes place and it absorbs light from photon. Methane on first step it can give chloromethane, which on further chlorination gives dichloromethane. One more method. Dichloromethane is obtained by reduction of chloroform. In this case also you can see the reduction, but that reduction is carried out directly by hydrogen gas in presence of nickel catalyst. So chloroform, it loses one chlorine in form of this HCl, and one hydrogen is added here, so that turns it into dichloromethane. So preparations, very easy. Now properties and uses. Dichloromethane is a colorless liquid. We'll keep in mind it's liquid with boiling point temperature 313 Kelvin. So you can see almost very low boiling point temperature, only because you can say that it's just 40 degrees Celsius. It is widely used as a solvent. The major use of this is a solvent. So as a solvent for paint remover, as a propellant aerosols, and a process solvent in many manufacture of drugs. So in pharmaceutical industries it is very important. It is also used as metal cleaning and फिनिशिंग सॉल्वेंट। नाउ विल सी द फिजियोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट। व्हाट डू वी अंडरस्टैंड बाय दिस वर्ड? दैट व्हाट इफेक्ट इट कैन हैव ऑन लिविंग सिस्टम। सो लेट्स सी, इट एक्ट्स ऑन सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम। सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट इफ इट इट इज इनहेल्ड और एंटर्स इन अवर सिस्टम, डेफिनेटली इट कैन कॉज द इम्बेलेंस इन नर्वस सिस्टम। एक्सपोजर टू स्मॉल लेवल ऑफ इट इन एयर कॉजेज स्लाइटली इम्पेयर्ड हियरिंग और विजन। यू कैन सी दैट हियरिंग एंड विजन बिकम्स इम्पेयर्ड। हायर लेवल ऑफ इट इन एयर कॉजेज डिजीनेस, नोजिया, टिंगलिंग एंड नमनेस इन फिंगर्स एंड टोज। डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट ऑफ इट विथ स्किन causes intense burning and mild redness of skin. Direct contact with the eyes can burn cornea. And how it was proved? That the cornea of animals was found damaged when exposed to vapors of it. So we have to be very much careful about this application. That it is generally used, I think we have just seen that it is used as a solvent. So when we use it, we have to be careful that it should not be in direct contact with skin or eyes. ट्राईक्लोरोमीथेन CHCl3, कॉमनली नोन एज क्लोरोफॉर्म। सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गिव IUPAC नेम टू दिस, इट इज गोइंग टू बी वन ट्राईक्लोरोमीथेन। Preparation. Chloroform is obtained by reaction of ethanol with dichlorine gas in presence of bleaching powder. So what happens in this case? That two chlorine atoms, one chlorine will react with this one HCl and another chlorine will react with another H, and that will be removed as twice HCl. Free valency of carbon and free valency of oxygen join with each other, that gives CH3CHO ethanol in first step, and that ethanol later on reacts with 3 moles of Cl2. Out of these 6 chlorine atoms, 3 chlorine atoms take away 3 hydrogen. Actually over here it should be minus 3 HCl. That gives CCl3CHO. So if you want to give the IUPAC name 1, 2, its IUPAC name will be 2-2-2 trichloroethanol. Now these trichloroethanol reacts with calcium hydroxide, that is of bleaching powder. That calcium hydroxide reacts with this and that gives a trichloromethane, that is called chloroform. Along with that, calcium formate is obtained as a byproduct. Chloroform is formed by partial reduction of carbon tetrachloride with the help of water in presence of iron. So iron reacts with water and that releases hydrogen at very slow rate, and that hydrogen reduces this carbon tetrachloride. From that it gives trichloromethane. Pure chloroform is obtained by the reaction of chloral hydrate with concentrate alkali, that is CCl3CHOH. Previously we have seen chloral, now this is chloral hydrate. So water molecule if added, that is called chloral hydrate, which on reaction with concentrated NaOH, that gives a CHCl3, sodium formate and water. So many reaction equations are there in this, so prepare carefully. Properties and uses. Chloroform is colorless liquid. Take care in this also. The substance is liquid. Its boiling point is 334 Kelvin. Comparison of boiling point you should always keep in mind. Its vapor is combustible. It possesses sweet smell. It is soluble in alcohol and ether. It is slowly oxidized by air in presence of light to form an extremely poisonous gas, that is carbonyl chloride. So carbonyl chloride, that is COCl2, which is also known as phosgene, popularly known as phosgene. See this. Okay. It is therefore stored in closed dark color bottles completely filled to the brim to exclude air. 0.61% alcohol is also added, which destroys traces of phosgene if produced during the storage process. Phosgene thus combines with ethyl alcohol and converts into non-toxic diethyl carbonate. So it converts into diethyl carbonate. So chloroform reacting with oxygen in presence of sunlight, that gives carbonyl chloride phosgene, and phosgene reacts with ethanol. We add, that is, you see that just we have seen that it gives reacts with 6.621%. We have added that converts into diethyl carbonate and HCl. Now this diethyl carbonate is non-toxic, so toxic phosgene is converted into non-toxic. Chloroform is used as a solvents for resins, oils and fats, alkaloids, iodine and many other substances. The major use of chloroform today is in the production of freon refrigerant, that is R22. So freons are always given numbers. In addition, it is used as anesthetic for making patient unconscious during surgery or operation. Now, physiological effects. It was once used as a general anesthetic agent in surgery, but has been replaced by less toxic and safer anesthetic agents such as ether. Inhaling chloroform vapors depresses the central nervous system. So here over you can see the word general. So two type of anesthetics are there. One is general and the other is local. So general is what? When a major surgery is to be done, a whole body is made unconscious, that is called general anesthetic. And if minor surgery is done, that much organ or the surrounding part only are made numb or having no sense, so that is called local. Now you can see that it affects on central nervous system. So but now you can understand that it has more toxic effect. Why? Because if it converts into COCl2, so definitely it is going to create danger for the patient. So it is not used nowadays. What is used is ether. So many other ethers, not just diethyl ether. Breathing about 900 ppm for a short time can cause dizziness, fatigue and headache. Chronic chloroform exposures may cause damage to the liver and to the kidneys. Some people develop sores when the skin is immersed in chloroform. So when the people are using chloroform, the person will have to be very careful, especially when the people or the workers using the chloroform as a solvent in industry. So the skin should not be directly in contact with chloroform. Tetrachloromethane, CCl4. So carbon tetrachloride also it is known as, and if we want to give the IUPAC name, it can be 1111 tetrachloromethane.
प्रिपरेशन टेट्राक्लोरोमीथेन इज फॉर्म्ड बाय रिएक्शन ऑफ कार्बन डाइसल्फाइड विथ डाइक्लोरीन गैस इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनहाइड्रस AlCl3 एज कैटलिस्ट CH2 कार्बन डाइसल्फाइड प्लस 3Cl2 इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनहाइड्रस AlCl3 दैट गिव्स कार्बन टेट्राक्लोराइड और टेट्राक्लोरोमीथेन एंड यू कैन सी दैट इज CH2Cl2 दैट टेक केयर इट हैज टू सल्फर एटम्स इन अ मॉलिक्यूल. टेट्राक्लोरोमीथेन इज फॉर्म्ड बाय क्लोरीनेशन ऑफ मीथेन सो दैट कैन बी ऑब्टेन डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम रिएक्शन ऑफ मीथेन एंड क्लोरीन गैस इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ अल्ट्रावायलेट रेडिएशन दैट इज एब्जॉर्बिंग फोटोन एनर्जी एंड वी गेट कार्बन टेट्राक्लोराइड. प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यूजेस कार्बन टेट्राक्लोराइड इज अ कलरलेस फ्रेग्रेंट लिक्विड हैवियर देन वाटर. इट इज इनसॉल्यूबल इन वाटर बट इज सॉल्यूबल इन इथेनॉल एंड ईथर. इट्स बॉइलिंग पॉइंट इज 350 केल्विन. CCl4 इज यूज्ड अंडर द नेम ऑफ पायरीन. सो व्हाट इज पायरीन? पायरीन इज द ट्रेड नेम ऑफ कार्बन टेट्राक्लोराइड फॉर एक्सटिंग्विशिंग फायर. सब्सटेंसेस लाइक ऑयल फैट पेट्रोल ऑल दीज आर नॉन पोलर सब्सटेंसेस एंड वाटर इज पोलर सो वाटर कैन नॉट बी यूज फॉर द सेम पर्पज. सो वी हैव टू बी टेक केयर दैट वेन एवर नॉन पोलर सब्सटेंसेस कैच फायर वी विल यूज कार्बन टेट्रा क्लोराइड. इट इज यूज इन द मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेंट्स एंड प्रोपेलेंट्स फॉर एरोसोल कैंस. इट इज ऑल्सो यूज एज अ फीडबैक इन द सिंथेसिस ऑफ क्लोरोफ्लोरोकार्बन्स फ्रियॉन्स एंड अदर केमिकल्स. इट इज यूज एज अ सॉल्वेंट इन द मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल्स. इट इज स्टेबल एट हायर टेम्परेचर. सी यू कैन सी वॉट हायर टेम्परेचर 773 केल्विन. सो इट इज स्टेबल एट 500 डिग्री सेल्सियस टेम्परेचर. एंड वैन इट कम्स इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद वाटर एट हाई टेम्परेचर इट कन्वर्ट्स इन टू फॉसजीन दैट इज अगेन अ डेंजर. वॉट डेंजर इज? वी हैव टू टेक केयर दैट वैन एवर वी यूज कार्बन टेट्राक्लोराइड एज अ फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर we will not use water only because these two will interact with each other and that will give you phosgene and triiodomethane CHI3 which is also called iodoform. So CHCl3 is called chloroform, CHI3 is called iodoform. So preparation of iodoform is also used as one of the tests to determine the alcohol which has OH attached with carbon which has CH3 group on adjacent carbon atom and for aldehyde and ketone also in which carbonyl group is attached directly with CH3 group. So we'll be careful that it is applicable for what? It is applicable to determine the CHOH. So this is alcohol that should have CH3. So OH containing carbon should have methyl group. And for carbonyl, maybe aldehyde and ketone, carbonyl carbon should have CH3 on it. These all substances means this group and this group can convert into CHI3. If you want to give IUPAC name, it is going to be 111 triiodomethane. Preparation: iodoform is formed by the reaction of alcohol containing CH3CHOH group. You can see over here that OH containing carbon has CH3 group. Or acetone with iodine. In acetone also you can find that CO has attachment CH3. Of course on both the side. Acetone with iodine and solution of sodium carbonate or dilute solution of sodium hydroxide. In short, basic medium. You can see ethanol reacts with ethanol that reacts with sodium carbonate and iodine that gives triiodomethane, 5 moles of NaI, sodium formate, carbon dioxide and water. So many stoichiometric coefficients you will have to remember in this. The other acetone reacts with 4 moles of NaOH, 3 moles of I2. That also gives iodoform, sodium iodide, sodium acetate, and 3 moles of water. So you are supposed to prepare both these equations carefully, only because it has so many components involved and different stoichiometric coefficients. Properties and uses. Iodoform is a light yellow colored crystalline smell possessing substance. That you can see over here, that it is the first substance we are coming across that has solid state. Its melting point is 392 Kelvin. It is insoluble in water but dissolves in organic liquids like ethanol and ether. As iodine is liberating iodine is liberated from iodoform, it is useful as an antiseptic medicine. Dichlorodifluoromethane, that is CCl2F2 freon, chlorofluorocarbon. If you want to give IUPAC name, what you can give is 11-dichloro-11-difluoromethane. As per alphabetic order, you can give chlorine first priority, then fluorine. Definition and classification. Chlorofluoro compounds of methane and ethane, in which all the hydrogen atoms are replaced by hydrogen atoms, are collectively called freons. These are further classified on the basis of fluorine atoms present in them. For example, CF4 is called freon 14. If no hydrogen atom is there in the substance, in no hydrogen atom, you see, then this first number one is used, and the later alphabet number is on the basis of the number of fluorine atom. In this, you can see that CF3Cl, 3 fluorine, no hydrogen, so 1,3. No hydrogen, 2 fluorine, so 12. No hydrogen, 1 fluorine, so it is, you can see, 11. Preparation. Chlorofluorocarbon is prepared by reaction between carbon tetrachloride and antimony fluoride at high pressure in presence of antimony pentachloride. Take care that we are using what antimony pentachloride as catalyst and antimony trifluoride as reagent. In Schwartz reaction, we have already written that heavy metal fluorides can be used for the introduction of fluorine. So substitution takes place by fluorine in over chlorine, so we get CCl2F2 and SbCl3. So this is dichlorodifluoromethane. These compounds have got a long series in which CCl2F2 is major, which is known as freon 12. Why? Because no hydrogen and 2 fluorine. Properties and uses. Freon is a colorless, odorless, and non-corrosive, non-toxic gas, which is stable even at high temperature and pressure. Its boiling point is 243. You can see that boiling point is really very low, and that is the reason that it is gaseous at room temperature. Metal does not corrode because of its effect. It is more used in refrigerator and air conditioner. Freon CCl2F2 and C2Cl2F4 series are used in them. Fragrant substances are used in aerosol mixture of insecticide substances. In these, freon 22, CClF3, CCl2F2, CCl3F, etc. are also useful. Environmental effect. Most freon, even that used in refrigeration, eventually goes to the atmosphere, from where it diffuses unchanged into the stratosphere. In stratosphere, freon initiates radical chain reaction, which can disrupt the natural ozone balance. So now we are switching over to DDT. That is para-paradase dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane. The name para-paradase dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane is a misnomer. It is एक्चुअली कॉल्ड 2,2-bis-4-chlorophenyl-1,1,1-trichloroethane. DDT was first prepared in 1873, but it was not until 1939 that Paul Muller at Geigy Pharmaceutical in Switzerland discovered the effectiveness of DDT as an insecticide. Paul Muller was awarded the Nobel Prize in Medicine and Physiology in 1948 for this discovery. Structural formula, you can see the formula. So first we will justify its common name. That is, this is ortho position, this is meta position, sorry, this is ortho position, this is meta position, and this is para position. In this we will say this is ortho dash position, this is meta dash position, or this is para dash position. So it is para and para dash, dichloro, diphenyl, and 1,2,3 trichloro, and total 2 carbon atoms, so it is ethane. And IUPAC name, you can see that it is, this is the first carbon, this is second carbon. On second carbon atom, phenyl groups are there, and on this phenyl group 1,2,3 and 4 position chlorine is there. So this overall group is called 4-chlorophenyl group, which appears 2 times, so it is called 2,2 into bracket 4, of course 2,2-bis-4-chlorophenyl-1,1,1-trichloroethane. Preparation: DDT is formed by reaction of chloral and chlorobenzene in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Properties and uses: DDT is a white solid substance. It gives pungent smell of chlorine and the eyes get irritated. There is a possibility of cancer if it enters the body. It can be easily absorbed through skin, so one has to be really careful when it spreaded over the muddy water. It is a cheap but powerful insecticide. It is widely used for sugarcane and fodder crops and to kill mosquitoes and insects. It is particularly very effective against Anopheles mosquitoes, which spread malaria, and lice that carry typhus. Through its use, malaria has virtually been eliminated from India and large part of the world. Tragic side effects: the use of DDT increased enormously on a worldwide basis after World War II. However, problems related to extensive use of DDT began to appear in the late 1940s. Many species of insects developed resistance to DDT, and DDT was also discovered to have a high toxicity towards fish. The chemical stability of DDT and its fat solubility further increased the problems. So if it is entering the body, it will definitely dissolve into fat. It stores for longer period of time in body and can cause damaging effect. DDT is not completely biodegradable. That is, it is not very rapidly metabolized by animals. Instead, it gets deposited and stored in fatty tissues for longer period of time. If this ingestion continues at a steady rate, DDT builds up within the animal over a period of time. This affects the reproductive system of animals. Because of these tragic side effects, the use of DDT was banned in USA in 1973. However, in India and in many other Asian countries, DDT is still being widely used due to the non-availability of any other cheaper insecticide and due to less awareness for human life. So one more already available as a substituent for DDT, it is 1,2,3,4,5,6-hexachlorocyclohexane, or it is also known as BHC, that is called benzene hexachloride.